So paleo diet is the next diet, and it is really based on foods that, if you think where the name came from, it came from the Paleolithic era, which was over 2.5 million years ago. So if you think about what was eaten at that time, I mean, the other names are caveman diet, stone age diet, hunter-gatherer diet. So the hunter-gatherer for me, because not everyone knows exactly what cavemen were eating, but if you think about hunter-gatherer, you think, oh, okay, so things that falling off trees that you get in the woods find, you know, if you're near a river, near a body of water, things that you would be able to access. So it's lean meats, you know, fish, fruits, vegetables, nuts, and seeds. So basically the idea with paleo is that the foods that became super common when the farming industry emerged. So your dairy products, legumes, and grains sort of started this issue where the foods were consumed at such a fast pace that it really outpaced our body, that our bodies weren't able to adapt. So that is sort of the reasoning behind, you know, obesity, diabetes, heart disease. I don't necessarily, you know, the farming isn't necessarily the only part of this because really in today's society and the majority of what people eat, we're eating so much prepackaged food that it's so much processed food and not necessarily just things that are coming from a farm. So it's just, I guess, the idea is that with farming and the legumes and the grains and really refining grains, then you turn all of that stuff from farming into processed food. So there is definite, you know, common sense behind this. So some of the benefit claims for the paleo diet, same sort of stuff. You know, lose weight, maintain a healthy weight. What you can eat on a paleo diet. So it's pretty vast. So fruits, vegetables, nuts, seeds, lean meats, so especially grass-fed or wild game. Fish, you know, the omega-3 fatty acid fish, so salmon, albacore tuna, mackerel. Again, mackerel is always, every time I give any sort of talk, it's always one of those fatty fishes that are in the list, mackerel. And I know virtually no one who eats that on a regular basis. So, but it is always around, but it's a nice alternative to think about because there are all these other questions than if you're recommending salmon, is it wild? Is it farm raised? Is it this? You know, so people get a little bit over, you know, inundated with kind of concern over where their fish is coming from. And the true benefits if it's coming from a farm. So oils is another thing from fruits and nuts. So olive is a fruit, and so olive oil would be great. Olives, walnuts, walnut oil. Things to avoid. So this is a really big list, and again, it's a lot of carbs and sort of the dairy stuff. And so it's any sort of grains, wheat, oats, and barley, which are all, you know, gluten containing legumes, so beans, lentils, peas, peanuts, dairy products. So dairy products meaning milk, cheese, yogurt, all of that family. Refined sugar, obviously cavemen weren't, you know, consuming refined sugar or salt for that matter. They might get a fish from a saltwater body, in which case there was some natural sodium in that. Potatoes is another one, and again, any sort of processed food. So nutritional concerns on the paleo diet is really, there are elements of a healthy diet is rich in fruits, rich in vegetables, and nuts. There are no grains or legumes, so really which are all excellent sources of vitamins, minerals, and fiber. And there's no dairy, which is an excellent source of protein, but also the best natural food source for calcium. Calcium is the largest mineral in the body, and people that don't really consume dairy at all have no chance of getting an adequate amount of calcium or anywhere near what they may need in a day. So the bottom line with paleo is that it really may help you lose and or maintain weight. There are some possible other beneficial health effects, but really there again with this, no long-term clinical studies. And a lot of this is sort of anecdotal. Most people know someone that did this and, you know, they talk about it for a while and they think, oh, you know, I'm going to start doing that. And then people start doing it and either have some success or not.